I'm live, setting the mood with some music, set me free. Hey, hallelujah. Hey, Lee. Hey, yeah. Getting ready. Hey, welcome. Real ghetto rig right now. Cool. Alright. Let me cut my ghetto rigness down. Amen. So, I'm going to jump right into it. Usually, these Periscope things have been lasting a long time, and I don't want to do that today. I am prepared. I have my notes on a separate device so that I don't get sidetracked, and I want to dive right in. I want to dive right in because I've seen some very interesting things on the news, online, and just around me, and that seems to be what these Periscopes have been driven toward. They have been driven towards addressing what's really going on. Bottom line, I seem like everywhere I turn, people are telling lies, living in lies, believing lies on purpose. And it's got to stop. Oh God, it's got to stop. I live in Charlotte, and I don't think this is the capital of it. Excuse me, but I've caught so many different types of people lying that it's ridiculous. Hey, Rick. Hey, hey. That's my bro, Ham. So, it's just the lies. Oh, God. I've never seen so many people that love to hear untruths. False, hey. Falsehoods and fables. It's ridiculous. Let me tell you how bad it is. Let's say, and this has happened, I heard someone call someone the B word. I was standing right there when the B word was said. I heard it, saw their mouth move and everything, and I go right off. I say, why did you say the B word? And they would look me in my eyes and go, I didn't say the B word. Like, just, the lies have got to stop, okay? And it's bigger than just people telling lies. I also believe that believing a lie is just as bad. And let me just be real. I'm talking about lies today because there's too many people being deceived. Way too many people being deceived. And here's what I really want to get at tonight instead of going all around the bush. What I want to get at is that if you're a child of God, you're free. He set you free when you accepted him as your Lord and Savior. When you accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, he set you free. Amen. Amen. So what is happening is when you were set free, took them shackles off, he opened up that jail cell, them doors, those hinges were taken off. And at the end of the day, ladies and gentlemen, excuse the text, at the end of the day, you were free to walk out when he set you free. When you say, yes, I believe Jesus is my Lord and Savior. When you say, yes, I will confess with my mouth. Basically, I'm going to not only think it and believe it, I'm going to say it. Once you've done that, you are free. You are no longer bound by anything. If it's from your past, your present, even anything that could possibly be in your future. You are not bound anymore. The issue that is happening is that either people don't know they've been free. Because again, I'm talking about the body. I'm not completely talking about, I haven't really addressed the non-believers yet. I'm still talking to the body of Christ. And I'm going to get a little deeper. I got to, you know, start soft and then we get to the middle. And people that don't know they free, you know, let me keep it real. You still dibbling and dabbling and behaviors that are, you don't want the church to know about. Sweetheart, you're free. And though that's easy to say, amen, thank you for the heart. Though that's easy to say, it's just what it is. You're free. And if you walk worthy in the cause of what God has for you, then you know what? You do not have to worry about carrying that weight, no shackles anymore. His word says to cast your cares upon him because he cares for you. Not only that, his yoke is easy. That was Zay. Oh, thank you, Zay. Yes, baby. His yoke is easy. His burden is light. So at the end of the day, I need for people who are supposed to know God to walk in their freedom. You know what I'm finding out is that people are believing the lies they were told. When you were told you weren't pretty, when you were told you wouldn't be anything, when you were told whatever, that night you was with old boy years and years ago with college, or when you was with old girl in high school and she said this, this, and this, and this, and this about you, good or bad, and you believed her. She lied, he lied, and you believed it. And though you are saved, and though you are farther than you were then, that lie is still in you. You still look in a mirror and thinking about and pondering about the things that he or she said. Or maybe you like me. The things that you heard as a child when they told you you weren't good enough. You were too this or too that. Come on with it. Come on with it. Yes. Amen. And there it is right there. I feel like sometimes I could just stop. We are way too busy comparing our lives instead of just living in truth. And the thing is that while you comparing the outside, you also got to fight your own inner demons and the things from your past. And I'm just here to say, Didn't she say it? I'm just here to say that bottom line, we're free, and God gave me this, and I'm going to say it right now. I ain't even going to hold up and build up to it. We need to stop decorating our jail cells. You putting up drapes and lamps and wall art and posters, and you getting a new couch. Why are you decorating your jail cell? Door wide open. Because it's easy. It's hard to believe the truth. Kid you not, everybody. I took like 27 selfies today. I liked this look. For one of the first times in my life, I looked at myself and said, hey, girl, you look good. And my husband looked at me and said, well, duh. I was like, I really like my profile. Look, there's my profile. I really like my profile. And he's like, I've always loved your profile. Because I believe the lies that unless I looked a certain way, lies I told myself. I used to tell myself I was fat. Y'all was with me in high school. Y'all see me. Everybody on the scope knows me. So I used to tell myself I was fat. All the time. Ain't he something? I used to tell myself I was fat and I'd kill for that body now. Would kill for that body now. So I have literally heard God saying we need to walk in his truth. There's just too much deception going on around us. Thank thee. I wish that's what I believed. We need to embrace his truth. We need to bury ourselves in his word. You know what's crazy is there are some sick people out here. There are some sick people out here. And what's sad is because there are so many people. And unfortunately, in the body of Christ, they got the Holy Ghost and everything else. They are quenching the spirit and they're not paying attention to what God's saying, but instead listening to man or themselves. I've said this before, but we can be our own worst enemy. Stop lying to yourself. If there's a problem, address the problem. In the last scheduled scope, I addressed how we need to call out apple trees. If there's no apples on a tree, then you need, where your apples at? If you're a banana tree, where's your bananas? That sort of thing. People won't have to call you out if you look at your own self, if you look in the mirror and tell the truth. Have God search your heart, and when he show you himself, show you yourself, then believe what he says and then trust him to come out of it. So if I were to label or list this scope for people who will watch later, We have to stop living in lies, because if you live in a lie, you are susceptible to believing more lies that can really be harmful to your salvation or your life later. Yes, it is. You girl, preach, Candace. It is the hardest part of working on yourself. But we have to remember, it's hard. Yes. Yes, Lee, they preaching today. We have got to do that. We've got to accept it, and we've got to examine ourselves, because at the end of the day, it's going to get ridiculous. Like when I see a kid, the lies are they come out so easily. They've done them so much. They don't even recognize they lying. And I don't want that for the body of Christ. Our Father is not the father of lies. So we have to work on ourselves, because people are watching us. They're watching us as this Orlando mess goes forth. They're watching how we treat the LGBT community. God forgive me, these fools that say they are in the body of Christ, that are celebrating the shooting of another human being, is despicable. And they're going to pay for that. Coming out, ooh, you're not God. Ooh, I'm not going to go there. But at the end of the day, they're watching us. It's disturbing to see. And unfortunately, it's getting very common. It is getting very common. And I'm at the place where, how are we going to reach the people who are lost in their sin, or lost in a lifestyle that they don't need to be in? Because in some cases, that's all it is. They have their own things they need to accept and examine their own lives so that they can come out of the lifestyle that they're in. And sometimes it's really simple. I'm going to give you an example, do a list, and then I'm going to be out. Told you I'm going to keep this short. I watched... It's going to always give you time, but you rearrange your letters so you can remember to smile. Oh, that's cute. Yes, indeed. I agree with that. Life will give you lines. And you know what we need to do as a body of Christ? When other people around us have lines, we need to show them how to rearrange the letters so they can smile. Kirk Franklin is coming to mind right now. I never thought that song would be useful till now. I smile. So today, I stumbled upon... Literally, this YouTuber called He Flawless. And He Flawless is an openly gay man who does makeup tutorials, and his makeup is really flawless. Lord Jesus. You know, I went to stylist. You have to forgive me. You got to give credit where credit is due. The makeup is flawless. And amen. So I watched a video. I don't remember why I watched it. And then I watched one that he did this year that said his molestation story. He was raped. And this happened when he was 7 or 8 years old. And he did all the details. And he said that he put it out there not for a pity party, but to inspire and encourage somebody else. I bet you do. Yeah. And I watched it, and I went ahead and commented on it today because it reminded me of stories I know about. Mine, praise God, was not as graphic as his. But I saw right there in listening to him, his pain. I could care less of him being a queen or using foul language, or even him rejecting comments of coming to Christ, or people calling him an abomination, all this other kind of stuff. Instead, my heart went to love. It went to love. It went to prayer. And then I saw the truth of what it is. The truth of what it is simple. At that time, that young man did not have somebody that he trusted, not even his own parents, to tell at that time that he had experienced a tragic rape from someone he trusted. They found it in a suicide note. Could you imagine if that man had committed suicide in high school? We wouldn't know his story. On top of that, long story short, me watching his videos and seeing how many people's lives he touched because he was brave enough to share what he went through, and then shared how he overcame and how he forgave. And my thing is, yep, his lifestyle is horrible, and right now he is coming against the harsh people, I guess, who would call themselves evangelizing him. He is coming against it now, but my prayer is, God, if you use him this way, think of how great his influence will be for the kingdom. I pray he accepts Christ. And see, why am I saying this? I'm saying this because all he needs to do in Jesus' name is just accept that the reason he is living in the lifestyle that he's living in is that that was a result of his tragedy, and that Jesus can deliver and wants better for him. But right now he got people bashing, and he has comfort in what he knows, and he's still healing. So if I relate his story and what I saw in his process to the body of Christ today, is that we need to be brave enough, as Leisha said earlier, as Candace spoke earlier, as Rico said earlier, we have to be brave enough to trust God with our pain. And see, that's the stuff that people cause upon us. We also have to trust God with our sin. We've just got to do it. We've got to do it, because at the end of the day, how many times we gonna look in a mirror and see a big gash right here and just go, the rest of my face is pretty, I'm straight. Baby, you got to wash that. The longer you leave dirt in place, the harder you gonna have to scrub to get it clean. I'm not real familiar with that because I like to keep myself clean, but I'm pretty sure if you just let dirt pile up, you wash all around everywhere else except for that area right there, you gonna break out. You might lose some epidermis. I don't know. Y'all don't know science that well. But at the end of the day, you can't just keep ignoring stuff. It's gonna get bigger and it's gonna affect, and people are gonna see it. I don't care who did what to you. Ask God to show you what lies are lying in your life, so that you can literally live and be set free. Some of us, we kicking it. We are out the jail cell, but we super close to it. Run. When that situation pop up, we run right back inside the cell. Who will sit on our couch and breathe? So you free, but you run back in when it comes to your parents. On the finish line, we fail to find the joy in the journey. Amen. Oh, honey, yes, it will become more transparent as you ignore the problem. Y'all aren't in Charlotte, but dear God, it's got to be other places. But I've never seen so many people. It's like right now, I'm wearing a scarf on my head. If somebody said, hey, you're wearing a scarf on your head, and I go, no, I'm not. While the scarf is still there, you don't take it off. Nothing. Just, I'm not wearing a scarf. Like, that's how people are today. Like, with their mouth. So I can't imagine what you are like in your spirit. It's got to be around, because we're, as the body, we're becoming ineffective, and we're supposed to be the salt of the earth. Salt is not worth anything if it don't have no flavor in it. And we can't play on both teams. This may seem harsh for people later, because the people on the scope, they got it. So if people can watch it later, this may sound pretty harsh what I'm about to say, but I'm gonna say it. If you willingly are walking in sin, walking in unforgiveness, walking in anger, walking in what you think is truth, your ways, you're constantly ignoring or disobeying God in any area. I don't care what area it is. Baby, you are damaging the witness for Christ. Will his work be done? Yes. The rocks will cry out. He will use who he needs to use. But you, my friend, are damaging the witness for Christ if you are not handling your business. I don't care how painful it is. It took me 23 years to call my father daddy. For a long time, it was his name, or I'd say he or you. He didn't have a name. I knew I finally forgave him when I said the word daddy to him. at the end of the day, I don't care, you know, what your life has been looking like or how much you've overcome. When God starts to show you more, I need you to just go ahead and get on it. As the song said, get set free. You are free already. Walk out of that jail cell. And here's the thing I'm finding interesting. Just hit me. So, you know, when you got saved, you was in that one cell, everybody in. And God said, you free, and you walk out. But you ain't quite out the institution yet. There's some more cells you can pass now. The doors are open. If you walk into the cell of self-pity, where you self-medicate or whatever it is you do, you still in bondage. Even though you got free from the cell back that way, you walked into another one. Stop decorating your jail cells. You don't live there. You're free. This just hit me. Nobody in this room lies. Like, they don't just go around telling lies. They don't do that. Love y'all. They don't do that. But anybody else that may stumble upon this when this hits YouTube or you watch the replay on Periscope, if you're a liar, little stories and white lies and cover-ups come out of your mouth to cover your butt for the heck of it, whatever. I need you to get that in order now. Because liars have their place in the lake of fire. He ain't playing. He's not the father of lies. He's the father of truth. So if you are still telling stories, if you are trying to cover yourself, well, I don't want to hurt their feelings. Well, baby, don't say nothing. If you don't have the cojones to tell someone the truth in love or with tact, then you just close your mouth. Stop lying. Every word that come out of our mouths, we will be accounted for. We cannot continue to live in lies. That is the opposite of what he wants us to do. It's kind of like having gangrene in your body. I'm going to keep it real again. I don't like going to church. There are some great churches out there. I don't like to go. It feels infected. Pastor may be straight. The word is good most of the time. Or the choir is straight. The building's cool. Whatever it is. There's always something like it's just is noticeable. It's like a fungus. And I guess where I am in my treatment of being rehabilitated, I can't deal. Not right now. And if I can't deal with it, having been saved since the 8th grade. Lord. Some things is just off, is what I feel when I go. Yeah. The people living in lies. They are living in those lies. And it's coming out. It reminds me of one of my family members. They're an alcoholic, simple and plain. Ain't no other way to put it. They've been drinking for so many decades now that even when they're not drinking, not so much now, but about 5 years ago when they walked past, you could smell liquor coming through their pores, even if they hadn't drank that day. They've been in it for so long. You didn't have to drink. It came out your pores. Or there's this mother, old church mother, from my old church who ate a lot of garlic, like daily. Even when she wasn't eating garlic, it came out her pores. Her house smelled like garlic, even when she going cooking it. Living in lies in church and being money hungry. So when we go to these places, these ministries, honey, you smell it. Even if you can't see it, you smell it. Your spirit go, uh-uh. For example, like I said, I'm going to get up off of here. Some of y'all might be mad at me again. I'm not feeling this this talk show, the preachers that's about to come on. I ain't watching that. No. I'm not even going to set myself up. I don't know. I believe that the body of Christ should have platforms and all that. Something about the commercial, I don't trust you. I don't care that it is Pastor Jamal Bryant and a couple of dudes I don't know. I ain't watching it. And then, in the same fashion, yeah, it's going to be on network TV, the ABC, CBS people. is commercial and something is fishy about it. And TD Jakes got one coming out too. I believe the same channel. I like TD. I like the word that God gives him. I ain't watching it. I don't. In my spirit, I hear sellout because it's network television. It ain't cable. It ain't HBO. It's not TBN. It's network. Mm-mm. I can't do it. I don't. If y'all watch it, y'all let me know. But I can't. There's something about it that just ain't right. I don't know. We got to guard ourselves. Those of us who are living in truth, your truth will make you free is what the word said, because it will. If you're walking in truth, you got to stay there. Because the longer you sit around a lie, it'll get on you. I can't do it. I can't do it no more. I can't do it. So, here's what it is, saints. Because that's who I'm talking to. Again, if you stumble across this video, you're like, I don't believe in Jesus. Baby, this ain't for you. Capitalism at its finest, because we rather believe scripted reality shows than that. Woo! Amen. Listen. Look, I ain't got to say much. Miss K is killing the game right now. At the end of the day, again, living in lies. You watching reality TV, but that's not reality. They got a script. Didn't she say it? They're living by a script. That's not reality. And what's messed up is because I teach with young folks, like in their early 20s as well as with teenagers, is that when stuff that happens on a reality show is not popping, if somebody ain't popping off at the mouth or there's not no drama, they're uncomfortable, they're squirmy, and then they'll create stuff because that's what they think reality is. They don't know how to be still and read a book and enjoy quiet and smile. If they don't, did you hear what they say? They come up with the craziest things. Sometimes for the money, and like the kids ain't get no money. So they're doing it for attention. So that's reality show. Like, now the reality show is hitting home. It's here. Yeah. It's too much. It's too much. And when you real, like I am, I'm keeping it real. God is correcting me on some things. That's why this is the topic. Living in lies. I can't live in these lies anymore. These little safe havens that I've been in. The end of the day, I get right, church, and let's go home. I don't know how this ties in, but I'm gonna share it and I'm gonna get off. I keep saying I'm gonna get off. I feel like a preacher. I need to cut it. Told you I teach teenagers. So I know, right? I know. You see, I'm talking a Periscope. Right. I read a news article. It found me about 2-3 days ago. In Australia, a father was arrested for sexually assaulting his, at the time, she was 11-year-old teenager, his daughter. He had been abusing her and letting other men, pedophiles, have sex with her, etc., for 2 or 3 years, it said, in Australia. When they caught him and arrested him, he's quoted as stating, "It was fun while it lasted," end quote. That burned me up. It burned me up, and the reason why I'm mentioning it, as well as the young man's molestation rape story, is I'm very serious. Very much so. It burned me up because many people won't know. I got it through an app, Clean Master of all apps. That's how the news story came up. I got an Australian news article. There are things like that happening all around us. Lord knows. I know. continue to be that way. Because a young man that got molested and raped when he was 7 or 8, that's gay, has his own YouTube series now. He got molested by a family friend with all his family in the house. Nobody suspected a thing. Excuse me. The deception is real. The enemy can't have you. If you've accepted Jesus, he can't have you. You know, he can tempt you. He can, for all kinds of things. Unforgiveness is a big one in the body of Christ. He can tempt you to hold on to grudges, all this other kind of stuff. Living lies, telling lies, selfish pleasures, being greedy, all kinds of different things. But my thing is when you're caught up in your lies, when there's big smoke screens in front of you, you can't see the hurt, the pain, the turmoil, the ministry that really needs to take place around you. I respect people that tithe and fast and faithfully go to service and pray. And I respect it. But the harvest is ripe. It's ripe. We have got to pay attention. We've got to pay attention. And not just pray for our families and friends, but pray for young people all over the world. Pray for immigrants all over the world. I saw another story this morning. Where in Pakistan, a man is a Christian. He was accused of tearing some pages out of the Quran. He was accused of it. He said he didn't do it. They were going to kill him. So he and his family fled the country and went to Thailand. Whole time I'm looking at the story, I'm wondering why Thailand, but I don't live in Pakistan, so who knows? In Thailand, he's being persecuted there. He did the proper thing, went to the UN for this, that, and the third, visa, blah, 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 blah. It's him, his wife, and his son, baby son. And his wife has a heart condition. Well, their visa was running out or whatever, and the immigration people of Thailand came and got them at their apartment, sent them to this camp, which is just inhumane. The conditions remind me of slave ships. From back when Africans and were stolen and sent to the Caribbean and to America. Anyway, his wife died because they wouldn't give her heart medicine. Even though he was in the right, basically he's being persecuted, like for real. And he's not the only one over there being persecuted. They are throwing Christians over buildings in the Middle East. They are taking our rights away here in America. And I say we got to examine ourselves so that when they start hurling the lies more boldly at us, we'll be able to stand on truth. Withstand the wiles of the devil. Because they're already doing it. They are bold enough to print these stories and put these things on TV. Because they have a feeling that people won't pray or stand up. There's a lot going on. And we can't afford to live in a lie. Is we've got to stop. We're free. And what we need to be doing is showing other people how to get free or that they're already free. Don't you agree? You think so? No? Yes? I feel as though people have left me. Well, I'm going to take that. Gracias. Okay. It's coming in now. yeah, I got notes out and didn't even read them. I hit on all of it, though. Even though I didn't look at them, I hit on all of them. Thank you so much to my participants. I had a couple of text messages come in during the scope, but we're live, so I can't check text messages when I'm live. I love you, all of you, for coming in. And if you're watching this later, I love you too. If by chance, because people like to start mess, let's say once this gets uploaded to YouTube, some of the things or people I talked about catch wind of this. Let me first and foremost say that if someone gets this video that he flawless, I want him to know, honestly, I love you. Just watching his personality, love him. Listening to his story and hearing him overcome his pain and very understandable tragedy, I understand. I empathize and sympathize. And I want him to know if he get it. Because, you know, people like to be, she threw shade. No, I didn't. You are a light that could be brighter if you just give your life to Christ completely. Right now, you are making your life out of this. You're getting your coin. And I'm not mad at that. You got to do what you got to do. End of the day, I don't care about any of that. I just need you to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Because you started your journey. He will completely finish it for you. Okay, I'm out for real. Share it, don't, whatever. It's going to get to whoever it gets to. I love you all. Check me out Sunday at 8. It probably won't be this heavy, but check me out on Sunday. I'll do these every Sunday and Friday at 8 p.m. And they're going to get shorter because I got notes now. All right. Love you all. Peace. And I am officially out. Love, peace, and chicken grease to you too. 23 Rick. Thank you, Miss K. Yes, yes. Love you too. And thank you, Lee. I don't remember your handle, but you know who you is. There it is. Love you too. All right. I'm officially out. Bye. Okay, I'm out now. 'll stop. That's funny. Really? What? Hey, Periscope people, it won't stop. That is hilarious.